हेलो 12th क्लास, दिस इज योर चैप्टर डेटा स्ट्रक्चर असाइनमेंट 1 सॉल्यूशन एंड लेक्चर नंबर 7. सो हेयर इज द आंसर्स ऑफ द असाइनमेंट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, डिफाइन डेटा स्ट्रक्चर. सो इट इज अ वे टू स्टोर अ कलेक्शन ऑफ रिलेटेड डेटा टुगेदर एंड द डेटा स्ट्रक्चर कैन बी इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द लिस्ट, डिक्शनरी, टपल एंड सेट. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय NQ एंड द DQ? एज यू नो, these two are the operations of queue. So NQ means insertion of element in the queue and DQ is deletion or removal of an element from the queue. Now next is, name some application of stack. So here is the answer, that is application of stack, reverse of a string or line. B is function call routine and C is backtracking. Now question number 4, name some applications of queue. So applications of queues are when a resource is shared among multiple users, for example printer. Second is ticket counter at railway station. Question number 5, what are the conditions associated with stack? So condition that associated with stack are overflow condition and the underflow condition. So overflow condition means it is a situation where we are not able to add new element due to memory full or range is overfilled with values. Now next is underflow condition. So it is a situation where there is no element left and we still wish to remove an element or display the list. Question number 6 is, write a program to implement the stack using list. And question number 7, write a program to implement the queue using list. In your previous class, I told you these two questions. Okay, so here is the code. You can see the code and write it in your notebook. Okay, this is the same code that I discussed in the video lecture. This is the peak function, reverse function, and here is the while loop. Okay, so this is the same program. Now, next is your queue. So this is your queue program. Here is a is empty. Now NQ function, this is your DQ function, this is your transverse function, next is your peak function, and here is your while loop. Okay, so this is your program of queue. Now question number 8, write a menu driven program in Python to implement the various method related to insertion and deletion in the queue. You know how to insert and delete in the queue. This I discussed in the previous class, in the previous video lecture. So you have to write the code from there, okay, and you have to write the it in a menu driven program. Mean user have to enter whether he wants to insert the element or delete the element from the list. Okay, this is question number 9. So this question is new for you. Here the question says, write push book and pop book method in Python to add a new book and remove a book from the list of books, that is considering them to act as push and pop operation of the data structure stack. Okay, so this book, here is the code. This is the push function. So you have to ask the user how many book you want to enter. Enter any number. So that number is append with the book and is the pop. Pop will delete the element. If the book is equal to empty, then the stack will empty. Else deleted element is book.pop, so that the first element of the book will get deleted. Question number 10, write add client and delete client methods in Python to add a new client and delete a client from a list. Okay, list of client name, that is considering them, that is considering them to as a insert and delete operation of the queue data structure. So you have to insert the element in the queue and then delete the client from the queue. Okay, so this is the code, def add client. So you have to enter the name from the user, ask the name from the user, then client.append, that will append in the list. And for deleting, if the client is equal to empty, then the queue will be empty. Else part, print the client, this one is deleted, and delete client. You have to delete this client. Delete function is there, or you can write the client.pop. Okay, so that a particular element will get deleted. In this you have to just write the method. That's why I have just written the method of add client and the delete client. Okay, I hope these questions are clear. Now tomorrow means on Monday you have a test of data structure. Okay, so be ready for the test. So thank you and have a nice day.